Good morning all of you. Today we will see the canal falls and regulations, that is drainage works. The definition of canal falls and regulations: a cross drainage works is a structure carrying the discharge from a natural stream across a canal, intercepting the stream, that is called as cross drainage work. Canals come across obstructions like rivers, natural drains and other canals. The various types of structures that are built to carry the canal water across the above mentioned obstructions or vice versa are called cross drainage works. It is generally a very costly item and should be avoided by. Now, types of cross drainage work. Depending upon the levels of discharge, it may be of the following types. The first one, cross drainage works carrying canal across the discharge. The structure that fall under these types, the first is an aqueduct and second in siphon aqueduct. Aqueduct. We will see the first aqueduct. When the high flood level of the drain is sufficiently below the bottom of the canal such that the drainage water flows freely under the gravity, the structure is known as aqueduct. Then crossing works, that is the adequate. This is the actual diagram of crossing works. You see here is the canal and there is the portion of river, and this is the actual region of crossing work. Siphon aqueduct. In case aqueduct and second siphon aqueduct. Aqueduct. We will see first aqueduct. When the high flood level of drain is sufficiently below the bottom of the canal such that drainage water flows freely under gravity, the structure is known as aqueduct. Then crossing works, that is the adequate. This is the actual diagram of crossing works. You see here is the canal and there is a portion of river, and this is the actual region of crossing work. Siphon aqueduct. In case of the siphon aqueduct, the HFL high flood level of the drain is much higher above the canal bed and water runs under the siphonic action to the aqueduct barrels. The drain bed is generally depressed and provided with pussy floors on upstream side. The drainage bed may be joined to the puka floor either by vertical drop or by glacis of 3:1. That is a 3:1. The downstream raising slope should not be steeper than 5:1. That is 5:1. When the canal is passed over, the drain, then the canal remains open the inspection throughout, and the damage caused by flood is rare. However, during the heavy floods, the foundation are susceptible to scour, or the waterway of drain may get choked due to debris or trees, etc. Then the actual cross drainage works. Cross drainage works carrying drainage over canal, and this is the layout. This is the actual picture of cross drainage work. The structure that fall under these types type the structure that fall under the type first is super passage, second is canal siphon called siphon only. The first super passage, what is meant by super passage? Super passage here is a to pierce and it is a FSL level, and the bank of the canal, that is the HFL, in between that stream. So it is the super passage, the hydraulic structure which in which the drainage is passing over the irrigation canal is known as, that is hydraulic structure which is the drainage is passing over the irrigation canal is known as super passage. This structure is suitable when the bed level of drainage is above the flood surface level of the canal. The water of the canal passes clearly below the drainage. And second is super passage. Super passage is a similar or adequate, except in this case drainage over the canal. The FSL of the canal is lower than underside of through carrying drainage water. Thus the canal water runs under the gravity. Reverse of an adequate canal siphon. If two canals cross each other and one of the canals siphon under the other, and actually this is the actual programmatic level of the HFL, and it is the this is the pier. Then the hydraulic structure at crossing is called canal siphon. That is the hydraulic structure crossing siphon. For example, lower Jhelum canal is siphonated under the Rasul Koribad Punjab Pakistan link canal, and the crossing structure is called LJC siphon. In case of the siphon, the FSL of the canal is much above the bed level of the drainage through, so that canal runs under the siphonic action. The canal bed is lowered and ramp is provided at the exit so that the tremble is silting minimized. And reverse of the adequate canal. In the above two types, inspection road cannot be provided along the canal and separate BG is required for the roadway. For economy, the canal may be flumed, but the drainage through the never flumed. Selection of suitable site of canal cross drainage works. The first is selection. The factor which is affect the selection is suitable types of cross drainage works are relative bed of levels and water levels, canal and drainage. Size of canal and drainage. For following consideration are important: when the bed level of the canal is much above the HFL of the drainage, and the adequate is the obvious choice. When the bed level of the drain is level above the FSL of canal, super passage is provided. The necessary headway between the canal bed level and the drainage HFL can be increased by the shifting the crossing to the downstream of the drainage. If however it is not possible to drainage the canal alignment, a siphon adequate may be provided. When canal bed level is much lower but the FSL of canal is higher, the bed level of drainage a canal siphon is preferred. And last is, when the drainage and canal across each other, particularly practically at the same level, and level crossing may be preferred. This type of works avoided as far possible. The factor which influence the choice and selection crosswalk. Which are the factors influence? The first one, the consideration which governs the choice between adequate siphon adequate are the suitable canal alignment, suitable soil available of riverbank connections, nature of available foundations, fifth, permissible head loss in canal, and sixth, availability of funds. Compared an adequate super passage in inferior and should be avoided when possible. Siphon adequate is preferred over siphon unless large drops in drainage bed is required. Classification of adequate and siphon adequate. Depending upon the nature of sites of adequate or siphon adequate, it may classify under three headings. The first type, sites of aqueduct in earthen banks which complete earthen slopes. The length of culvert should be sufficient to accommodate both water section of canal as well as earthen banks of the canal with aqueduct slopes. Sides of the aqueduct in earthen banks which other slopes supported by masonry wall. In this case, canal continues in its earthen section over the drainage, but outer slopes of the canal banks are replaced by retaining wall, reducing the length of drainage culvert. Second type, sides of aqueduct may of concrete or masonry in this earthen section of the canal is discontinued and canal water is carried in masonry or concrete trough. Canal is generally flumed in this section. Thanks to all.